AM WVTM 13 Chief Meteorologist Jason Simpson, and yes, we do have more active weather on the way in central Alabama. Impact weather on Saturday and Sunday. Here's what you need to know. First of all, it's going to be hot. Highs in the 90s, but the heat index around 100 to 105. A few strong storms are possible. I think those will come in at least two distinct waves, potentially three waves, depending on how they maneuver around the state and how much rain-cooled air they lay down. And within the storms, they may not all be severe, but they could have some gusty winds, very heavy rainfall that could lead to some flash flooding. And there's also the potential for lots and lots of lightning, these prolific lightning producers. And if you get one of those lightning alerts on your phone and you got plans to be outdoors, whether it be UAB's fan day, some kind of practice, football practice, cheerleading practice, whatever it might be, going into the month of August as school has started, just make sure that you're flexible with your plans. You don't have to cancel your weekend plans. Please don't cancel your plans just based on the forecast for one round of storms on Saturday and another round on Sunday. Just be aware that you have to be flexible and be alert. So here's what the weekend looks like. A high around 91 with a heat index 100 to 105 on Saturday. The better chance of storms in the afternoon. And then yet again on Sunday, a pretty good chance of storms coming up in the afternoon as we work on through the late part of Sunday, Sunday night. There could be yet another wave that comes in going into Monday. So this is just before 4 o'clock. Showers and a few thunderstorms still showing up on WVTM 13 Live Doppler. They are much heavier southwest of Montgomery, and there is nothing more for tonight around north and central Alabama. You can see that one wave going down to the south. There are clouds around, but even these are starting to thin to the north of Birmingham. So what we get for the next 12 hours, well, it's just going to be kind of more of the same. Mostly cloudy sky. Temperatures are in the 70s as we work on through tonight. A low temperature close to 73 in the Birmingham area. Well, here's what's going on with it. We've got this area of high pressure out to the west. The upper airflow making sure that well, things just stay active around here. And it also helps to pump in the heat. So you've got the heat, the humidity, and an unusually active jet stream. That's what's been causing this pattern all summer long. So here's some of the timing that we expect on Saturday. Again, it's not going to rain the whole day, nor will it rain every minute of these windows of time. This is just when I think your best chance of a thunderstorm would be. 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. northwest Alabama, Lauderdale, Colbert, Franklin, Marion, maybe even Winston, Fayette, Lamar County could have this before 2 p.m. From around midday through early afternoon, Tuscaloosa, Jefferson, Shelby, Cullman, Blount, St. Clair, Talladega, Calhoun, Etowah, and Cherokee counties. You notice up here toward, say, Sand Mountain and Lookout Mountain, there may not be quite as much storminess up this way. This next round may be a little geared more toward western Alabama than toward the eastern side of the state. So that's something we'll watch throughout the day tomorrow. Be sure you're watching Briley early tomorrow morning to get the latest on it. Storms will move south on Saturday night. And then on Sunday, we've got more heavy thunderstorms coming in the afternoon. Storm Prediction Center actually has a marginal risk of severe weather up for Sunday. And then Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, it's more of the same, locally heavy storms likely.